Hello friends, welcome to my channel CBC Tutorials by Anjali Arya. Today I am going to explain you the concept molarity. So what's molarity? Now molarity means the number of moles of solute present in 1 liter solution. Okay, and the formula also goes like that molarity, which is denoted by capital M, means number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. Okay, the volume of solution should always be in liters, and you have to calculate the number of moles of solute. So if I ask you, for example, if they have given you that the molarity of sugar solution is 2m, now it means that over here in this sugar solution the sugar is the solute. So 2 moles of sugar, that is the solute, are present in 1 liter of solution, that is 2m, that is the molarity is 2m. If I say that the molarity of H plus ions in a solution is 3m, it means that 3 moles of that H plus ions are present in 1 liter of solution. Okay, so that is what is molarity. Now let's solve some questions to have a better understanding of molarity. Okay, so in this question we have to find the molarity of 40 gram of NaOH, which is dissolved in 250 ml of solution. So the formula of molarity is number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. So we don't know the number of moles of, in this the NaOH is solute, but we don't know the number of moles of solute. They have given us the mass, so we are going to calculate the number of moles. Now if you remember, there was a formula that number of moles is equal to the given mass upon the molar mass or the molecular mass. So we had this formula where number of moles was equal to the given mass upon molar mass. So we are going to put this formula to find the number of moles. So the given mass given to us is 40 upon the molar mass of NaOH. Now for Na it is 23, that is atomic mass. Then for oxygen it is 16 and for hydrogen it is 1. So 16 plus 1 is 17, whole divided by volume of solution. Now the volume of solution is 250 ml. But we have to take the volume of solution only in liters. We cannot take it in ml. So we are going to convert that 250 ml into liters. So it becomes 250 by 1000. Okay. So that 250 ml becomes 250 by 1000 in liters. So now we have to solve this. Now this becomes 40 by 30 and then 40 into 1000 by 250. Okay. So this becomes 1 and this becomes 1000 by 250. So for this you get 4. Okay, 1000 by 250 is 4. So 4 moles. So this becomes 4 moles per liter. Okay, so your molarity over here is 4 moles per liter, or you can write it as 4 capital M. That is 4m is the molarity. So in this question we have to find the mass of Na2CO3, which is present in 100 ml of 3m solution. So over here 3m means the molarity is given to us, that is 3. And they have also given us the volume of solution. So we have got the volume, we have got the molarity. But this time we have to find the mass of Na2CO3. But in the formula we have number of moles of solute. So in place of number of moles of solute, we can write given mass upon molar mass. Right, we can write that given mass upon molar mass in place of number of moles by volume of solution in liters. And here we can we have to find out the given mass. Okay. So for that, first 3 is the molarity, so we'll write 3 over here. We have to find the mass, so in place of that we'll write x. Then the molar mass, or the molecular mass of Na2CO3 will be, sodium is 23 into 2 plus carbon is 12 plus oxygen is 16, 16 into 3, 48 upon volume solution in liters. So again they have given us the volume of solution in ml. So it is going to be 100 by 1000 in liters. So we always have to convert the volume of solution which is given to us in ml into liters. So this becomes 3 by 1000. So when you further solve the question and when you find out the x, you get the value of x to be 31.8 grams. That is the mass of Na2CO3. So this time we have to find the molarity of 10% weight by weight aqueous solution of H2SO4, and the density of the solution is given as 1.1 gram per milliliters. So first you see that for instead of giving us the weight of H2SO4, they have given us that the weight by weight percentage of H2SO4 in the aqueous solution, that is H2SO4 in water, is 10%. So we have this percentage composition formula where it is, this is in terms of percentage composition. And the formula for that is mass of that quantity, particular quantity whose percentage composition we are talking about. Like over here we are talking about H2SO4. So in place of mass of the quantity, we have mass of H2SO4 in that solution upon mass of the whole compound, which means here it is water because H2SO4 is present in water. That is why it is H2SO4's aqueous solution into 100%. So when you do this formula, you get it as 10% weight by weight solution of H2SO4. So how do you get 10%? You will get 10% only when the mass of your quantity, that is H2SO4, is 10 grams by mass of your compound, that is your solution, will be 100 grams into 100%. So if the following masses were like this, then 100-100 would have got cancelled and you would have got 10 grams, you would have got 10% of H2SO4 weight by weight solution. So only when your mass of the quantity was 10 grams and your mass of the compound would have been 100 grams, only then you would have got 10% weight by weight solution. So what does this mean? This means that 10 grams of H2SO4, okay, 10 grams of H2SO4 is present in 100 grams of solution. So this 10% weight by weight means that 10 grams of H2SO4 is present in your 100 grams of solution. Okay, so we got the weight of H2SO4. Now let's find the molarity. Now all of you know that the formula for molarity is number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. So for finding the number of moles of solute, we can do it as given mass for molar mass. The given mass over here is 10 grams and we can find out the molar mass of H2SO4. But for the volume of the solution, they have not given us the volume of solution, but they have given us the density of solution. So with that, we can find out the volume of solution. Like they have given us over here that 1.1 gram of solution in 1 milliliters. Right, so the density was like 1.1 gram of something, you know, it is present in 1 ml of solution. So here we have, according to this weight by weight percentage, we have 10 gram of H2SO4 present in 100 gram of solution. So we have to find the volume of solution. So if 1.1 gram is present in 1 ml, then when we have 10 grams of H2SO4, what will be the volume of the solution? Okay, so we have to find that. So for that we will do 10 by 1.1, which will be 100. So 100 ml is the volume of your solution. So you have got the volume of a solution. Now we can find the molarity. Now molarity is equal to number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. So in place of number of moles of solute, we are going to write the given mass, that is 10 grams, upon molar mass of H2SO4. So when you calculate the molar mass of H2SO4, what you get is, it will be 2 plus sulfur 32 plus 64, which will give you 98. So upon 98, okay, because number of moles is equal to given mass upon molar mass, so given mass will be 10 upon molar mass or molecular mass of H2SO4 is 98 by volume of solution liters. We have found the volume solution in ml, in liters it will be 100 by 1000. Okay, so now when we further solve this, so when you further solve it, you get the value to be 50 by 49. You can further do it in decimals if you want to do. And the answer will be moles per liter, 50 by 49 moles per liter, or you can say that many capital M, that is the molarity. Now before we move on to the next questions, let's understand some terms. Now if they give you in the question as molar, it means that your molarity will be 1 and that the symbol will be 1 N, capital M. And if they give you it is bimolar, it means your molarity will be 2 and the symbol will be 2 M. If they give you semi-molar, it means molarity is 1 by 2, symbol is M by 2. If it is given as decimolar, it means molarity is 1 by 10 and the symbol is M by 10. And in case of centimolar, the molarity will be 1 by 100 and your symbol will be M by 100. So let's solve some questions. So in this question, we will deal with the molarity of ions. And whenever you have the molarity of ions, first you find the first and the foremost step should be that you find the molarity of the compound of whose ions you have to find. Okay, in this, like I have given separately to find the molarity of the compound, then the two ions. But usually, if they give you to find the molarity of the ions, first find the molarity of the compound, then only you can find the molarity of the ions. So let's solve this. So first, they have given us 53 grams of Na2CO3 is dissolved in 500 ml of solution. So first, we'll find the molarity of Na2CO3. So molarity is number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. In place of number of moles, we can write the given mass, which is 53, upon the molecular mass, that is 23 into 2 plus 12 plus 16 into 3, 48, upon volume of solution, that is 500 ml. So we will convert it into liters. So when you solve this, it becomes 53 by 106 upon 500 by 1000. So when you solve it, now when you solve all of this, you get the molarity to be 1 m. Solve it by yourself and check, the molarity will come as 1 m. Now let's find the molarity of the two ions. Right, so let's see how to find the molarity of the respective ions. Now, if you see this Na2CO3, if you dissolve it in water or whatever, if you dissolve it, it will give rise to 2 Na plus ions and 1 CO3 to minus ion. Okay, because Na2 it is given here, so that Na plus ions is 2 and the CO3 minus 2 minus ions is only 1. Okay, so these many ions will be given by Na2CO3. And if you write the number of moles here, this whole Na2CO3, there is no number in front of it, so it is 1 mole. And here you have a 2, so there are 2 moles of Na plus, and here you have nothing, so it means 1 mole. That is, if you have nothing, it means 1 mole. So 1 mole of CO3 with 2 minus is given. So when 1 mole of Na2CO3 is dissolved in water, it gives rise to 2 moles of Na plus and 1 mole of CO3 2 minus. Okay, so you understood this. Now in the previous one, we found out that the molarity of Na2CO3 is 1 m. Now, I told you in the starting only that when they give you something like 1 m or 2 m, that the molarity is 1 m or 2 m something, that it means that the particular number of moles of the solute is present in 1 liter of solution. So here also molarity is 1 m. It means that 1 mole of Na2CO3 is present in 1 liter of solution. Okay, only then the molarity came as 1 mole. So 1 mole of Na2CO3 is present in 1 liter of solution. So if you see that 1 mole of Na2CO3 gives 2 moles of Na plus. So if 1 mole of Na2CO3 is dissolved in 1 liter of solution, so it will give rise to 2 moles of Na plus in 1 liter of solution. Because if 1 mole gives 2 moles, then if 1 mole is dissolved in water, that is in 1 liter of solution, so definitely it will give the same number, that is 2 moles in 1 liter. And similarly, if 1 mole of Na2CO3 gives 1 mole of CO3 2 minus ions, then if you dissolve that 1 mole in 1 liter solution, so it will give rise to 1 mole only in 1 liter of solution. So if you have 2 moles in 1 liter of solution, it means that the Na plus, that the molarity of that will be 2 m, because 2 moles of that particular solute is present in 1 liter of solution. Similarly, for that CO3 2 minus ion, the molarity will be 1 m, because 1 mole of that particular is given in 1 liter of solution. So basically, the number of moles of solute in the volume of solution is what is molarity. So we have found out the molarity in the two cases. So this is how you do for the molarity of ions. So first you have to find the molarity of the respective compound, and then you have to see it like this, you have to compare it, and then you have to find the molarity of the respective ions. Now let's see what happens when they have given us two quantities with different molarities. Now over here, for example, you have two quantities, and in both the quantities, the number of moles of the solute is same. Okay, suppose here 5 is the number of moles of solute, and here also there are 5 number of moles of solute. But the volume is different in both the cases. The volume is in liters only, but the volume is different in both the cases. So definitely the molarity also will be different in both the cases, because it depends upon the volume of solution. So the volume is different in both the cases, the molarity will also be different in both the cases, but the number of moles of solute in both the cases are same. So we know that the molarity is equal to number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. So for finding the number of moles, we can do it as mv. So here, this is the number of moles of solute of initial, and this is the number of moles of solute final. So here we can take the molarity to be m1 and the volume to be v1. And here we can take the molarity to be m2 and the volume to be v2. Now, just now I said you that the number of moles of initial and final are the same. Just the molarity and the volume is different. So that means that your m1 v1 will be equal to m2 v2. Okay? So this is a formula, and this formula is used when two quantities are given and you have to find the molarity. So let's solve one question based on this formula. So in this question, they have given us that 0.2 m, is that is the molarity 0.2 of HNO3, and it is present in 100 ml of solution, and that is diluted with 100 ml of water. So we have to find the new molarity. Okay, so we have got the formula here. So by using the formula, we can place the values and find out the new molarity. So let us take this for the HNO3, let us take that to be m1 and m2. Okay, so 0.2 into volume 100 by 1000 is equal to, that is you have to find the numerality. So let us, that is you have to find out m2. Now the volume of water is 100 upon 1000. Okay, now when you solve this, so in this situation we won't take it to be 100 ml, we'll take it to be 200 ml, because if you see that it is diluted with water. Now if you see here, HNO3 was diluted with water, that is the volume of HNO3, which was 100 ml, that was diluted with water, which means that 100 ml of water was mixed in that. So 100 plus 100 will be 200. So the new volume will be 200, and we have to find the molarity of the new solution. So here we are going to take the volume to be 200, okay, and then solve it. So when we further solve it, so when you solve the following thing, you get the new molarity to be 0.1 moles. So here, so again I'll explain you, here we had one molarity. What happened is, first we had HNO3, then that HNO3 was diluted with water, okay. So it was diluted with water. So it was HNO3 plus water. So in case of HNO3, our M1 and V1 was normally that 0.2 and 100 only, but we had to find this new molarity. But since HNO3 was diluted water, so the volume of that would get added up, because this is mixed into this, this is put into this, so it gets added up. So that 100 ml of this plus the new 100 ml of water gets added up and becomes 200 ml, and then we need to find the new molarity. We have to just use this formula, m1 v1 is equal to m2 v2, and when you use the formula and solve for the question, you get the value to be 0.1 moles per liter. So now we are going to talk about molarity of mixtures. Now here I have taken, suppose we have three containers. Now in the first one we have certain number of moles. For example, let's say we have two number of moles. Here we have three number of moles. So in the third container, it is a mixture of these two. When we are going to mix this two, this third container is formed. Okay, we are going to mix these two to form this third container. So if we mix these two, the number of moles also gets added up. So here the number of moles will become 5. Number of moles is just a number, it gets added up if you mix two different quantities. So we have mixed these two quantities and we have got a third quantity, that is the mixture of these two. So here, in place of number of moles, in the previous one also we took it to be m1 v1, because we know that it is number of molarity is number of moles upon volume solution, so number of moles will be mv. So here for the number of moles of the first one, we'll take it to be m1 v1. For the second one, we'll take it to be m2 v2. And for the third one, now in this one, if you see, if you mix these two mixtures, these two compounds, what happens is the volume just gets added up. Okay, volume will just get added up. It's just that your molarity will change, because molarity changes according to the volume of solution. Here, if you mix these two, the volume just gets added up, but the molarity will be changed. So for that, you'll take it to be normal m, and in place of v, you'll write v1 plus v2. Okay, now with this we can say that number of moles of the first one plus number of moles of the second one gives us the final number of moles, right? So in place of that, we can write the following values, that is in place of n1 we can write m1 v1 according to the molarity formula, then in place of n2 we can write m2 v2, and in place of n we can write this v1 plus v2 whole into m. So with this we get this formula for finding the molarity of mixtures, that is m1 v1 plus m2 v2 whole by m, okay, sorry, whole by v1 plus v2. So with this we get this formula that m1 v1 plus m2 v2 by v1 plus v2 is equal to the whole molarity of the new mixture formed. Okay, so this is the formula for finding out the molarity of the mixtures. Okay, so we have here a question related to the molarity of mixtures. Now they gave us that 0.2 molarity and 100 ml solution, HCl solution, is mixed with 0.1 molarity and 300 ml of HCl solution, and we have to find the molarity of mixture. So this is also very simple. You had two HCl solutions, you mixed them and you found a mixture of the two HCl solutions. So for the first one, the M1, V1 were respectively 0.2 and 100. For the second one, it was 0.1 and 300. And when you mix these two, the volume gets added up and it becomes 400. We have to find the new molarity. You have got the formula over here also, that is M is equal to M1, V1 plus M2, V2 upon V1 plus V2. So do this question all by yourself and comment the answer in the comment section. And with this, we have completed the concept of molarity. And I hope you understood each and every bit of this video. So thank you for watching it, and if you liked it, please press the like button and subscribe to my channel CBC Tutorials by Anjali Arya. Thank you.